Welcome to FAR, the photographic series. In this series, we are going to guide you through cameras and photographers, their problems, their solutions, and a lot more. Do keep watching. Welcome to another episode of the FAR, the photographic series. So today what we are going to talk about is the problems that budding photographers face in the start. They are very common problems and there are obviously solutions to those problems, but which most of the people neglect. So today we are going to talk about that. The first problem that I noticed that photographers have faced are the right camera decisions. As I spoke in my previous episodes, that you should know what your forte is, then decide your camera. So that is the first thing. Second thing is the budget. Obviously, photographers are low on budget. So choosing the right lens, choosing the right camera is very important, because once you invest your money into that, then definitely you cannot take a back step. And moving from a Canon to a Nikon is like moving from a Windows PC to a Mac PC. It is absolutely opposite. So you cannot think of doing that later on in life. Maybe even if you do that, it will take a lot of struggle and effort, because everything is totally opposite. So I would recommend you that you do that first. Secondly, the problem that most photographers today face is getting clients. It is a very, very difficult thing to get clients, obviously, because you are a budding photographer. And obviously, people in today's generation want to see your work first. I mean, nobody wants to give you a chance without seeing your work. And you have invested so much money, so you are looking to even recover your money with that. So there's a two-phase mode which you have to go through. First, I would recommend you that you start shooting for free. Develop a portfolio, do a collaboration, do all those things in which you have a portfolio, in which you can, when you want to start charging a client, you can definitely show something to them. And definitely do not show bad work, because the first impression is the last impression. So unless you're not confident that your work is up to the mark and up to what the market standards are, do not charge. Do it yourself. I would not recommend having multiple things. Obviously, you will say that in the start, we cannot compare my work with a photographer who's 10 years into the industry, because he's got the money, he's got the right equipment, he's got so much employees, he's got a lot of things which you do not have. So obviously, your work cannot be compared up to that level. I would say, don't see it that way. Rather see it that take up a small work which you can do in a comfortable zone. Supposingly, I'll give you a small example. Try to take up house ventures for free. Your family will be happy. They will show you your negatives. So once you know your negatives, you know where you have to improve, obviously. And that is the only thing that can help you improve. Because family will give you always a positive attitude towards, and they'll always help you, push you or boost you towards your work. They will not say that this is bad, you should not do this. They will just tell you what is wrong. And then it is upon you to understand how to make it right. So with practice, you will learn that how to exactly shoot. And once you learn shooting, then definitely you can charge. In case you have any questions, any queries, anything that you want to ask us, please do mention it in the comment box below, or you can contact us on info@bxstudio.in. If you like the content of this video, please make sure you like, share and subscribe. Hey friends, this is A.Roshan, your very own house friendly photographer. We are going to talk about a lot of camera techniques, problems faced by photographers, and a lot more throughout this series. So do keep updated with the FAR series.